Museums are tools that humans use to understand the natural world. A museum of natural history is like a window into the way the natural world works. We're located here in Ithaca, New York, one of the most beautiful places in the eastern United States. It's geologically spectacular. What a wonderful place to put a museum that interprets all of that. We need places that focus our attention on the most amazing things in the natural world that give us questions as well as answers. Why a museum of geology, paleontology, and natural history in Ithaca? Because PRI was here, and because geologically it's one of the most spectacular places you could put a museum. The founder of PRI, Gilbert Harris, was a pure paleontologist. He taught at Cornell for almost 40 years. He took the extraordinary step of starting his own scientific enterprise, his own institution. Actually laid the cornerstone himself in June of 1932 with a few friends gathered around. In the 1990s, PRI realized that to support the science that was at the very core of the institution, it needed to have a broader base of support. It needed to have public outreach. And also the institution really looked at itself philosophically and said, what good are all these collections, these magnificent collections built up over more than a century, if only a couple of dozen people look at them? That idea was developed in the early 1990s by one of our board members, Ray Van Hout, and his vision was to allow this scientific resource to serve the general public. We are in the business of gathering together a collection of fossils. It's the basis for increasing scientific understanding, that is, discovering new knowledge about the history of life on Earth, and sharing that knowledge with the general public. When we started the Museum of the Earth project, we felt that we had to really make an architectural statement. We felt that we had to not only have extraordinary exhibits, but we had to have an extraordinary building.
What was actually essential in this project is imagining the whole site, the whole landscape, in helping answer the question about how biology, how geology are inextricably linked.
What's intriguing there is a kind of topographic drama of the region. The actual formation of that landscape, these cleavages in the soil that became weak, that became gorges, were what inspired and shaped the design in two parts as opposed to a singular element.
The beauty of the gorges, the way the lakes traverse the landscape and shape it, the presence of water, had a tremendous influence in how the design evolved. There's a very significant drop from Trumansburg Road to where the museum is sited. That actually can be an extraordinary opportunity because it provides a variety of vistas to the museum and from the museum.
The Museum of the Earth building is extraordinary by any stretch of the imagination. It's both a statement about geology itself, a statement about how humans interact with the Earth, and it's a marvelous envelope for all the exhibits you see here. This is not just the Museum of Paleontology, this is the Museum of the Earth, past, present, and future. And whales are icons of the state of the world today, the state of the natural world today. Whales are probably one of the best illustrations of evolution you could possibly imagine. Almost everybody knows that whales aren't fish, even though they swim in the ocean and they look like fish. Whales are mammals. But how can whales be mammals? They don't have four legs, they don't have fur. So automatically, there sets up a kind of a thought process. If whales are mammals, then maybe evolution works. And so we wanted a whale because whales are such fantastic illustrations of the evolutionary process. Mastodons were actually first described in the late 1700s from New York State. So we knew that if we were going to have a museum here in New York, that we had to have a mastodon. What were the chances that we could have stumbled onto one of the best mastodons ever found anywhere? We wanted art to be a big component of what we told the public. And into our door walks this extraordinary woman named Barbara Page. She had started thinking about time. She began to wonder how she could express time, and she eventually landed on this concept of one page or one panel per million years. And each image was a life-size representation, an actual fossil from the respective period of time. We commissioned Barbara to finish the work that eventually became Rock of Ages, Sands of Time. And we actually told our architects that they had to design the building around this 500-foot mural.
We would hope that someone who visits this museum is hungry to think about the relationship that we have to this earth.
Ideally, it's going to create a level of awareness and sharpening of peripheral vision in the way we all experience the world.
Really, this museum is just a statement about our understanding of the history of the planet and a statement about our role in its future. So I suppose if I had to pick just one thing that I hope people leave with, it would be a belief that what we do on Earth matters. What we do to understand the Earth matters, and what we do to the Earth matters.